Amen. I want to preach to you from this subject, I'm blessed on purpose. Turn to one of your friends and tell them, neighbor, I'm blessed on purpose. Amen. Y'all know I like to have a subtopic, and I got this from Pastor Steve Green, amen, more than comfort in Birmingham. He said he's a Krispy Kreme kind of guy, amen. He liked to wait to see where the light is on that, amen. And then when the light is on, it means what? The donuts are hot, amen. And in prayer, and praise and worship, I kept hearing the song saying, God, it's not about my mama, not my daddy, but it's about me, oh Lord, amen. Do a work in me, praise God. So if I had a subtopic I would share with you, I'm not going to hinder the blessing. Tell somebody, I'm not going to hinder the blessing now. Now, I wanted to say stop the blessing, but the Holy Spirit said you can't stop it anyway. Amen. You can try to hinder it and slow it down. But what God want to do in your life, even the people who don't like you can't stop it. They might be able to hinder it, but I'm going to have church with somebody and tell them they can't stop what's on your life. They can only hinder the blessings of God. Amen. I'm excited to be where we are, and I want to take this time since we're talking about spiritual maturity and growing up in Christ to deal with the fact that we are blessed on purpose and show you how that ties into Abraham and what Abraham has to do with us. Amen, somebody. Because how many of you know God is moving everywhere? Amen. He's moving locally. He's moving nationally. He's moving internationally. I wouldn't even be a good pastor if I didn't ask you to pray and remind you on Thursday it is the National Day of Prayer. Somebody say the National Day of Prayer. Thursday, 12 noon, we'd be downtown Gadsden. And we ask, even if you can't make it, if you got to work, to just pray. Praise God. I've been asked to come and be a part of that and to say one of the prayers of the seven prayers that's going to be prayed. So I've counted a joy and a privilege and an honor to be able to come there and share with the National Day of Prayer. Give God some glory. Amen. I want you to know that you have been blessed on purpose. And the Spirit began to just quicken in me while I was sitting there just this morning that sometimes we don't even recognize that God has blessed us for a reason. And what I want to do is I want to take this fellow by the name of Abraham, who we all know is called the father of faith. Somebody say the father of faith, or a progenitor of the nation of Israel, so you'll understand that he is the one that the promise was made to. Amen. There's some things that God said about Abraham that he was going to do, and now you have to get the revelation that when we came to Christ, we were baptized into Christ and we became heirs to the promise that God had made to Abraham. I promise you, man, if you ever get this revelation, your whole life will change, because you will know that every promise that God made to Abraham, they also apply to you. Look at your neighbor and tell them you're more than blessed. Amen. You got to understand this word blessed. There's some supernatural meaning to the word blessed. How many of you tired of just the natural being on your life? I mean, you ready to see some supernatural? When we say supernatural, we're talking about some stuff that man cannot do for you. The only way it's going to be done is God will have to do it. Come on. Reginae needs something done in her body right now that man cannot fix. But I'm bold enough to believe God that she can get a different report next week than what she got on last week. Come on, sometimes we just have to make a bold declaration and believe that God will add some super on top of our natural. The word bless, y'all, get this now, has to do with healing. Somebody say healing. Yeah, it means prosperity. Somebody say prosperity. Well-being for your family and salvation for your soul. Can I say it again? The word bless, come on, means healing. It means prosperity, well-being for your family, and salvation for your soul. I'm talking about our natural. That help us to know what to do with it when we got it. Come on. Because the story of Abraham is knowing what to do with what God has given you. Come on. When God has put something in your hand, we got to be good stewards of it to make sure we know it is not all about us, but we got to turn around. Y'all don't want to praise God for him and be a blessing to somebody else. God has, listen, here it is. We're going to give you a shortcut now so you can go and get your praise out of the way. You're not waiting on God to bless you. God has already blessed you. What you're waiting on is to mature and grow up and to realize what God has already done, so God can go ahead and trust you with what God has already done. Come on. Tell your neighbor, Abraham is the man, y'all. Yeah, when God made the promises and all that stuff I just got to read, reading to you, verses 1 through 8, God was making promises to Abraham. Abraham is the man. Abraham, tell your neighbor, Abraham is the man. Amen. Abraham is the man. He's the stem. Get this. He's the stem. He is the stem. He's Abraham is the stem. Please don't miss this. From which it all began. If you miss this, you'll miss everything. Abraham is the stem, which is all began. When God made promises about what he was going to do, I'm going to multiply you, I'm going to bless you exceedingly, abundantly above you, I'm going to take you into Canaan, into the promised land. He gave those promises to Abraham way before the law was ever put in place. So you got to understand that when the Bible talks about Jesus coming down through 42 generations, if you go back to Cain and Abel, it's way more than 42 generations. So the 42 generations only started with Abraham. Please get this, y'all. Let's go. I don't have this in my notes. Can y'all take me to Matthew chapter 1 because I don't have this in my notes. Let me just give you a visual aid and show you some scripture on this so you will have a better picture of what God is talking about and so that you will know that you're already blessed. This thing blessed me as I was sitting there because I recognized that we can be in a place to where we can hinder what God wants to do. Amen. The book of generations of Jesus Christ, the son of David, the son of Abraham. Okay, verse 2. Thank you. Abraham. Everybody say Abraham. Abraham. Now notice it's telling us the genealogy, the background, the pedigree, or the lineage of Jesus Christ. But it started with who? It starts with Abraham. So in order to understand this, you got to know that the 42 generations didn't start in the Garden of Eden. Cain, Abel, Seth, none of those guys. Methuselah, it started with Abraham. So when God started making promises, the promise was made to Abraham and his descendants. So it tells us here, Abraham begot Isaac. Isaac begot Jacob. Jacob begot his brothers. Okay, verse 3. Let's go to verse 3. Amen. So it says, Judah got for Perez and Zerah by Tamar. Perez, he got Herzon and Herzon, he got Aram. But the point that I'm showing you here is the 42 generations started with Abraham. Abraham is the stem from which it all began. And so God has to deal with Abraham to get the blessing in place, just like many of you in here right now, in order to get in your life, in your family, to your children, what God's trying to get to them. He got to get some stuff done in you. And what God showed me while I was sitting over there, he just gave me the revelation this morning. I didn't ever saw it before, that while Abraham was tripping and hindering the blessing, he was hindering Jesus Christ from all the way. I want to have church with somebody in here right now. Jesus had to come down through the lineage of Abraham, but there was a time in Abraham's life when Abraham was not fully following God, so Jesus could not come down through his loins. Come on, somebody. Abraham produced the seed. Isaac, he passed the seed. Jacob, he multiplied the seed. Come on. Joshua came and rescued the seed. Moses went down to Egypt and delivered the seed. All God was doing was passing Abraham's seed all the way down through the generation until Jesus. I wish I had somebody just so he could get Jesus. Look at your neighbor and say, who are you hindering right now? Who are you hindering right now? What are you holding up in your life? Because you won't grow up and get processed. You won't stop staggering at the promises of God. When God is trying to bless us, we are hindering. I wish I had somebody that would give God praise right now and tell your neighbor, I'm not going to hinder what God wants to do. Come on, give God a big old praise right there, somebody.